Everybody knows that poets have a lot of sex. They tumble vividly into the beds of friends and peers, destroying marriages and furniture, get claret on the linen, then write it up in copperplate, obliquely, with sufficient hints to give the editor a clue to the identity of each and each, and always hoping for a good review.